Hey guys, in this video I will show you some examples of combining Python and Excel. In particular, we will analyze a dataset and create interactive charts like the following sales calendar to plot the sales amount for each day. Additionally, we are going to split the data into multiple workbooks. Okay, and without further ado, let us get started. The purpose of this video is to inspire you and to share my tips and tricks. However, keep in mind that your particular use case might be different. Unfortunately, there is no one-size-fits-all solution. Also, on my channel, I have already many tutorials on combining Python and Excel. Therefore, I will keep the explanation in this video very brief. Instead, I will recommend some of my previous videos when going through the code. Those videos will explain the concepts in more depth. And with that out of the way, let us look at what exactly we are going to do. First, we will read data from Excel and store it in a pandas data frame. The pandas library is like Excel on steroids. With that module, we can manipulate and analyze data. To make the analysis more accessible, we will plot interactive charts before exporting the result back to Excel. In addition, I will also show you a small automation example to split a giant data table into multiple workbooks. But before we jump into the code, let us have a quick look at the Excel file. I've got here transactional data for a fictional store. For this tutorial, we are mainly concerned with the order date, the subsegment, the sales and the profit. In total, we've got over 3,300 records. To kick things off, we need to install the required dependencies. We will need pandas, OpenPyXL, Plotly Express, and ExcelWings. You can install those modules by typing pip install followed by the module name. I will, of course, also upload this notebook to my GitHub page. In the repo, you will also find the requirements.txt file. Okay, and with that out of the way, I will import the libraries. So, pandas as PD, Plotly Express as PX, and ExcelWings as XW. Additionally, I'm going to import path from pathlib. Pathlib is a standard Python library, so no additional installation is required. We will use pathlib to work with the different file paths and to create various folders. The next block of code is optional. For plotting different charts, we will use Plotly Express. Plotly Express comes with different styling templates. I personally like the Plotly White theme. So I will set that theme as the default one. Okay, and after importing the dependencies, let us get the data from Excel. The Excel file is located in the current working directory and in folder called data. To create the data frame, I'm using pd.readExcel followed by the Excel file path and the sheet name. To validate that it worked, I will print out 5 sample rows from this data frame. Okay, so this seems to be working. We have now our Excel data in a pandas data frame. Before analyzing the data, I usually print out a concise summary of the data frame using the info method. This method will return the following overview. I typically check if we have null values on our data, which is not the case. Additionally, we can see for each column the respective data type. For example, pandas converted the order date column to a datetime object. And that is pretty handy as we could now extract additional information from that date. In my case, I would like to insert a separate month column. To extract the month, we could type the following. Next to the month column, I would like to calculate the profit margin. So far, we only have the respective profit and sales for each record. To calculate the profit margin, I will divide the profit by the sales. Let us validate this by typing df.head. This method will print out the first 5 rows of our data frame. If I scroll to the right, we can see our new columns. The first thing that catches my eye is the negative profit margin in the second row. So, how about digging further into the dataset by clustering the data based on the subcategory? In Excel, I would typically do a pivot table. Also, in pandas, there is a pivot function available. Yet, I usually tend to use the group by operation. In my case, I would like to group our data by the subcategory. In particular, I would like to sum up all numerical values. After running this cell, pandas will return the following data frame. Summing up all numerical values doesn't make sense for the row ID, postal code, month and profit margin, but that is okay. What I think is more interesting is checking out the profits for each subcategory. At the bottom, we see that the tables generate a significant negative profit. At this point, it might be a good idea to plot the data to make our analysis easier. For this, I will be using the Plotly Express library. In my case, I'm using a bar chart on the group data frame. On the x-axis, I will plot the subcategories, while on the y-axis, I will show the sales. The cool thing is that we can also indicate the profit contribution by setting the color to profit. A low profit should be marked as red. In contrast, a higher profit should be displayed as a green bar. Optionally, we could also set a title for our chart. After executing this line, we've got our interactive plot. I like this chart because we can easily spot the subcategories with a negative profit and how much those subcategories contribute to the overall sales. By looking at this, we might want to see if we could find the root cause for the negative profit. One idea could be to use a scatter plot to see any relationship between the total profit and the discount we are granting to our customers. Creating a scatter plot is very similar compared to the previous bar chart. The interactivity of the scatter plot makes it easy to zoom into any area of this chart. Now, it may not surprise you, but it seems that the higher the discount, the more money we are losing. The question would be whether this statement is true for all the subcategories. Therefore, I will calculate the average discount by subcategory, and next to it, I would like to show the total profit amount. Let us also now plot this new data frame by using a bar chart. By looking at this graph, we can see that the binders have the highest discount rate among all subcategories, yet they are still quite profitable. So we might need to do more analysis focusing on the tables. But for this video, we are already happy with our findings. I just wanted to show you some possibilities of using the Python ecosystem to analyze data and to create interactive charts. And there are so many excellent Python libraries available, which will help you with your work. Another library, it's called PyCharts. I will not go into the details of the following code, as I plan to create a separate video for this. But in brief, I'm just bringing the order date and sales columns in a specific format before plotting a sales calendar. This calendar shows us the generated sales by each day of the month. We can see that we have generated more sales starting from the second half of the year. Also, you can use the slider to set the boundaries of the sales. As I said, I plan to do a dedicated video on the PyCharts library in the future. I just wanted to show you what else would be possible with Python. Now, back to our initial analysis. As a last step, I want to export our findings. To keep things organized, I will create three different folders. One folder for our analysis, one for the charts, and the last one for the automation example, which I will show you in just a moment. To create the folders, I'm using the pavlib module. In the past, I have also created a quick start guide for using pavlib. I will link that video in the info card above. So, after executing this line, we have our new output directory with the subfolders. Next, I will export our charts to a standalone HTML file. You can do this by using write_HTML on the chart object, followed by the output path. As a result, we will find our charts in the output folder. You could now share those files with your managers or colleagues. Alternatively, we could also inject the charts as an image directly into the original Excel file. To do this, we are going to use the ExcelWings library. To get you up and running with ExcelWings, I recommend checking out the following video, which I will also link to the info card. I forgot to mention that we also need the Kaleido, PSUtil and Request library to export the plotly charts to Excel. The easiest way to get those modules is via pip. So pip install Kaleido, PSUtil and Requests. With that said, let me guide you through the code. As a first step, I'm initializing the Excel instance. So this line will open up Excel on your machine. By setting visible to false, Excel will start in the background. Next, I'm going to open our workbook that contains the data. In that workbook, I will add a new sheet. We will now utilize this new sheet to add the charts. Therefore, I'm using pictures.add followed by the chart object and the desired output cell. Next to the charts, in cell K1, I will insert our group data frame. As a last step, I will apply some styling to our sheet. So I will set the background color of the header to blue and make the font white and bold. AutoFit will expand the column width for each row. Before saving our workbook to the output folder, I will also set the sheet name to analysis. Okay, and after executing this cell, we've got our new workbook, the two charts and the data frame. The last example I have for you is a small automation idea. If we look at our Excel data, we have a column with the different cities. For this example, I would like to save the data for each city in a separate workbook, so that I've got one workbook for every city. To achieve this, we could write a simple for loop. I'm using the pandas method unique on the city column to list all cities. I can now iterate over that list. Using the query function allows us to filter our data frame for each city in that list. I want to save the filtered data frame to our output directory. The file name should be equal to the city name. In Excel, the sheet name cannot be longer than 31 characters. So, just in case the city name is longer than that, I'm cutting it off by slicing the string. Now, executing this line might take some time, but we will have our new workbooks in the cities folders once done. And just to validate that it worked, I will open up one file. This workbook now only contains the data for one city. So I hope this gave you some inspiration on analyzing or automating your own Excel files. However, in real life, the data you are dealing with might not be always so clean and tidy. In fact, speaking of my own experience, the data I encounter looks often like this. We have a merged cell as a header and some remarks which are not relevant for our analysis. Also, at the bottom of this sheet, we've got a total sum row. Now, reading in this dataset is possible in pandas, but it requires you to specify additional parameters. Like the sheet name, how many rows from the top pandas should skip, which columns you want to use, and how many rows you would like to read in to exclude the total sum at the bottom. So every time I try to do some quick analysis, I found it always pretty tiresome to specify those parameters just to get started in pandas. That is why I have developed an Excel add-in to do this job for me. Now, full disclosure, this add-in only works on Windows, and there are two versions available, a free and a paid one. The free version offers already a ton of cool features. Let me shortly demonstrate to you some of those features. After the installation, you will find a new ribbon in Excel. You could, for example, highlight cell ranges, insert tick marks, or even create a table of contents as a gallery view. In the paid version, you could also create a pandas data frame by clicking the following button. You can then select the cell range you want to convert to a data frame. Once done, you will find a new Python file in the workbooks directory. The add-in has now inserted the code to read in the Excel data correctly. Alternatively, you could also create a Jupyter notebook. You just need to click this button and select the cell range. Optionally, you could also provide a title. After hitting OK, we have a new Jupyter notebook in the workbooks directory. This Jupyter notebook will look like this. We've got here our title and the code to read in the Excel file. We could also validate this by printing out the data frame. If you are interested in this add-in, check out the link in the description below. By using the coupon code YouTube20, you will also get a 20% discount on the Pro version. Okay guys, and that is all for this tutorial. As always, if you have any questions, please let me know in the comments. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.